tired of the line, sneaking around, and waiting, always hoping to spend a few hours with you?
Please, Rob, I need more time.
What for?
You don't love him. We both know that. All you're doing is plain inevitable. Carol, I want you now.
I said I need more time. I'm not ready yet.
I'm sorry, you will never be ready. Hello? Oh, hello, Jason. How's the Hookerman account going?
Cut! Mary, where was the freaking sound cue?
Hey, don't yell at me. Steve changed the line again.
I did not.
Yes, you did. You were different every time.
What is the line supposed to be?
I am starting to believe that you will never be ready.
What did I say?
I'm starting to think you'll never be ready.
That's the same thing.
No! You said I'm instead of I am. Think instead of believe. And you'll instead of you will.
Mike, I give up. Andy, you deal with her.
Hey, I go by the script. If you can't remember your lines, that's not my problem.
Can we get on with this? I have to get out of here on time today.
All right, Steve, just say the line the way it's written.
I like my way better.
Just say the line the way it's written.
My character wouldn't say something like that. It ruins the whole scene.
But just say
it! No, damn it! Why should I ruin my character I spent 6 weeks working on just because that meathead can't figure out when to push a friggin' button?
Up yours,
and,
pal!
And knock it off! How do you want to say the line?
I'm trying to think you will never be ready.
Fine. You write it down that way and you don't change it again.
Fine.
Did you get those flats finished yet?
No.
Why not?
Because they won't fit on paper.
What do you mean?
I mean, they won't fit out the door.
Why not?
Because they're too big.
Aw, hell, come on!
Andy, I have to leave at 4.
I know, honey.
Sarah, you can't wait forever. I mean, even Andy's not that stupid. He's going to figure out something's going on between us.
Shut up.
Okay, he's your boyfriend.
That's right. We've been going out for 3 years, and before I throw that away for someone like you, I'm going to be sure enough.
Just what is that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
Okay, baby. Just because you're feeling guilty about cheating on your boyfriend, don't start dumping on me. You know the situation. Go away anytime you like.
Oh, is that what you told Ashley?
What?
What? You remember Ashley, don't you? She's the girl from the last production you were in. She said you were the most wonderful guy she'd ever met, right up until the moment you dumped her. We had a very interesting talk about you yesterday. What's the matter, hon? Nothing to say.
Okay, so maybe I wasn't too nice to Ashley, but that doesn't mean... Line!
Oh, hell, Richard! Every time we get something started, you forget your lines.
It's not my fault.
Then whose fault is it?
I've got more lines than anyone else in this stupid play. And I've had strep throat for the last 2 weeks. I still can't breathe.
Why don't you grow up?
What is your problem?
My problem? I'll tell you what my problem is. I'm stuck in this lame production with a bunch of amateurs who don't know how to act, and a director who thinks he's God's gift to theater. This play is going to be the biggest flop in the world. This is how I get to end my acting career.
What do you mean? You're not quitting the play, are you?
No. My parents' business is going bankrupt. There's no money left. I have to drop out of school.
Can't you get a loan?
I've already got every loan there is. There just isn't any money. Cut!
Okay, Val. This time, I want you to kneel when you cry instead of sit.
Think it makes any difference? This thing is so confusing. No one's gonna know what's going on anyway.
She's right, Pam. This place sucks.
I know this isn't Shakespeare, but it's going to be a great play.
Yeah, right.
Well, we have to try. What do you want to do? Quit? Fine. Go ahead. But you can all kiss your equity cards goodbye.
Don't you think I know this play sucks? But this is my first paying job as a director, and I am going to make it work. And if you don't like it, you can go to hell.
This is
Go to hell, this I walk in and say. This is Smith. There's a call from the office.
I'm Bambi.
There's no Bambi in this play.
What are you talking about? What am I talking about? We've done this a million times. You say, if any of you don't like it, go to hell. At your Bambi. That's me. And then I say,
something weird is going on here. You say I'm just an actor playing the part of a director?
Oh, so am I! So am I.
Could have sworn I was directing this play.
No, you were just playing the part of the director who was directing a play that wasn't really a play.
I guess I got into the part a little too much.
Obviously.
Say, this may be a really stupid question. But who is the director of this play?
What?
Who's the director? I can't seem to remember.
Well, I'm directing one of the plays.
No. That's a fake play. Who's writing the real play?
What do you mean the real play?
Not the plays and the plays, but the play of everything in it.
I don't seem to remember who the director is. I mean, it got so confusing with all the plots and whatnot.
Hello? Is anyone out there?
Second fake play.
The second fake play?
Yes.
Okay, so who's the director?
We're not sure.
You're not sure.
Yeah, it's all a little confusing.
Yeah, great. Well, when you figure out who the director is, tell him we need a new Fresnel and some blue gels. I'm gonna go get a smoke.
This is ridiculous. I mean, someone must remember who the director is.
Well, when we got here this evening, who else was here?
Well, nobody. Rod and I had just gotten back from dinner. No, that's the play you're doing.
Oh. Yeah. Rod, do you remember what happened?
My name isn't Brad. It's Steve.
No, it's not. Your name is Bob. Steve is the character you play in the second play.
Oh, right. I knew that. Thanks, Scott.
My name isn't Scott.
What is it?
Carol.
No, I'm Carol. Hold on, I think you're Mark, I'm Tom, and you're Tony.
Is it Tony the VCOM vet who dies of heart attack?
Thanks, this is too strange. I'm going home. Does anyone remember where I live?
You live at 22 East 56th Street with a quadriplegic wife, a suicidal daughter, and a son who's afraid to reveal his homosexuality.
Anyone else? You live at the state hospital for the criminally insane committed after shooting 6 people at the mall.
A homicide. Where you are waiting for results of your AIDS test.
I think I'll stay here.
Well, we still don't know who the director is.
Perhaps I can help answer some of your questions.
Who are you?
Are you the director?
You might call me that. I do indeed direct events, although unlike your pathetic little play acting, my direction takes place within the realm of the real. I deal with lives, not parts.
Are you God?
Ha! Hardly. Although for a short time I did work for him.
Then you're the devil!
Some men call me that. Others call me Satan, Beelzebub, Lucifer, Mephistopheles, the Prince of Darkness. As for myself, I much prefer being called.
Hello. Oh, hello, Jason. How's the Wickerman account going?
Sorry, my bad.
Some men call me Satan, Beelzebub, Lucifer.
Oh, forget it. It was really, really lame.
You've all been condemned to hell for your sins.
Shut up already.
And lose a cheesy accent while you're at it.
It wasn't cheesy.
Was any cheesier? People could put it in a can and spray it on crackers.
I thought it was- was good. Besides, the devil thing was a cool idea.
Yeah, not like it hasn't been done 8 million times before.
Well, what if I was an angel instead of the devil?
Angel? Devil? It doesn't make any difference. You still can't act.
Identity, home, they're all just meaningless concepts, and we're all just figments of someone else's imagination. We get up in the morning, put on our clothes, makeup, walk out the door, and spend all day letting other people write lines for us, choreograph our movements, and direct our lives. They tell us what to do, what to think, who to love, and who to hate. And then one day, you wake up, and you're not you anymore. You just some same character.
Last line of your monologue. You need characters, someone else's play. I can understand.
Oh, right. Sorry. Or, do you think I should pause a little longer and say it softer? Like, now?
No, I like it better the first way. Has more emotion to it.
Fishing with my father. I remember it was a bright and sunny day and the seagulls looked like delicate little clouds. My father told me we needed to buy bait first, so we went to this little shack underneath the boardwalk. There was an old immigrant man with a scar across his face and horrible yellow teeth. My father told him we needed to buy bait, so the old man opened up this big can. And my father told me to look inside, and I did, and there were thousands and thousands of worms squirming and crawling all over each other with their blind faces staring straight at me. I started running and screaming, and I ran down the beach until finally my father caught me and took me home. So you see, Josh, I can't marry you, I'm sorry.
Oh, I get it. But should be kept from the play or the character from the play I'm supposed to be in when it's both or neither.
Well, your character in the play is a handsome young man from a wealthy Eastern prep school. But he killed a beast from the floor. On the other hand, your character in the play that you're supposed to be in the play is a small, evil-smelling, dwarfish con man who pretends to be blind on the streets of New York. However, he doesn't die. So, what we have here is a basic philosophical question. Is it better to be handsome, rich, and die young, or short and smelly, and get stepped on by a horse but not die?
Gosh, it's a tough one.
Yeah.
Mine's got cut.
Sorry to interrupt, folks. Just have to change this level. Won't be a minute.
I was talking to Frank down at the union hall the other day.
Yeah.
What did Frank say?
Said it was all over with.
They're gonna
UGA said they had to take them out and put in the 33.9s. We ain't got them.
I said my kid's brother-in-law had some of that ozone stuff at work. Yeah, now he's got cancer.
You look like you're talking.
You could probably try one of those 3368s up in there. This kid came home for Christmas. We're like strangers. Oh, we sit and watch the games, talk about the weather, but we really don't say anything.
When I was 17, I thought I was so tough. I was gonna rule the world. Now
I used to know what life was about.
Jeff, I just thought of something.
Yeah?
We never tried the light switch.
But we didn't. Kinda like life.
How do you?
You have to try to turn it on.
What if you don't know how, Jack? What if you don't know how?
I don't know.
You know, this reminds me of when I was a little girl. One day I went fishing with my father. I remember a bright sunny day and the seagulls. You already did that.
So?
So it was stupid the first time.
Sorry I'm late, but Bobby and I had to make a stop on the way.
Yeah, I know what they were stopping for.
Where's Bobby? He had to drag some of the guys to get cans to play, but
he'll be back. Shannon, did you see how Bobby put out of here? He almost smashed into the Wilson's car.
He was just fooling around.
No, he wasn't. He's drunk.
No way. He only had a couple of beers.
What, a couple of six packs? How can you let him do that?
What, am I his mother?
Besides,
he'll be fine. Why don't you just...
I don't believe you. You say you love him, but you let him drink and drive. If he was my boyfriend...
But he's not, is he? Why can't you just accept the fact that he's my boyfriend and not yours?
Oh.
Here, Jennifer. Have a beer. Or does that go against your little SADD rules?
Tom, what's wrong? How was the police, There's been an accident. He's dead.
No.
No.
Why didn't I take his keys? I knew he was drunk, but I just stood there. I guess I didn't want to look like a nerd. I guess I didn't really love Bobby either.
I can't believe it. He was just here. I just talked to him.
There must be some mistake.
No. The only mistake was this.
There's one thing I want to know.
What's that?
Who's Bobby?
I thought you guys knew him. I never heard of him.
And what about those two girls?
Yeah, who are they?
That was weird.
Still, it's a shame about Bobby.
Oh, yeah. He was a great guy.
Hey, the new stuntman just spilled his coat down the soundboard. What do you want me to do?
We don't know who the director is yet.
Okay, great. Well, when you figure out who he, she, or they are, tell them we need a new Fresnel, some blue gels, a new sound man, and a new soundboard. I'm gonna go get a smoke.
Wait. What's his name?
Crew chief.
No! Your real name.
That's all it says here. I'm gonna go get a smoke.
But don't you want to know who you really are?
I'm gonna go get a smoke.
Actors.
Sorry, I'm late.
Who are you?
Not Tomasa. Not even.
Where's Melissa?
Who are you?
Okay. All right.
Tuesday, I gave you all a big lecture on how irresponsible actors are because they're always late. Okay, the director's late today. I'm sorry. Made your point. I've had one of the worst nights of my life. I'm afraid we have something to talk about.
You're the director?
You idiot! Did you hear a word of what I just said? My husband, the man I swore to love forever just 6 months ago, told me this morning that he was very sorry, but that he's fallen in love with another woman. Ooh. And was leaving me and going with her to Florida.
Not Florida.
Do you know what I'm gonna do? I have to move back to Columbus. I'm not even a year in New York, and I'm running home to my mommy and dad. Sorry, there's just no way I can break this right now.
Florida.
Wow, that was really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when she started out angry and it got louder and louder, and then a little choking noise used to be right when she started crying. It was incredible.
I don't know, it wasn't bad, but I feel like it would have been much more effective if she was more devastated. Almost out of control with grief.
He's too calm.
What are you talking about?
Your scene.
What scene? What's wrong with you? Much more emotional, touches the audience
more. Definitely, but I think she needs some of the lines. Something to say to me.
Yeah, especially the one about the witches and horrors. We've done like a million times. Have you all gone insane? This isn't some play I'm talking about. This is my life.
Oh my god. I know what's been going on here. We've all become so wrapped up in our own lives, even our parts in this stupid play. We can't even see when someone close to us is in pain. We've become unfeeling robots. What happens to us? We all try to be good. We all mean well, but somehow that isn't enough. Please forgive me. Please forgive us. All right, who blew their cue?
Carol, if you'll come tonight, mm-hmm. I shall leave you forever. You're not going to leave my own way.
Brad, what are you doing with that gun?
Bro.
Second. And if I have to come to do it, so be it.
No, Brad. I won't let you.
No, no. Stop.
You know, this reminds me of when I was a little girl.
I remember it was a bright, sunny day. You've all been condemned to hell for your sins for all eternity. And now I shall return to my office in hell.
I've told you before, Roger, can only be one director in a production, and I am the director of this play. For your information, you're not Laurence Olivier. You're not even Keanu Reeves. Oh, you want to be the director? Go ahead, because I quit.
She's dead! Oh, the pain! The pain! I can't live anymore. I'm gonna kill myself!
Real.
I'm dying! The face of death approaches! guess.